Now we are going to start with a new topic, that is the isolation of elements, right? So the isolation of element is that, like, we classify element into different categories as metals, non-metals and metalloids, right? So you know that we are just going to study about the metals mainly in this topic. So you come across many things in daily routine, like you come across jewelry, you come across the utensils which you use, you come across a battery, you come across the buildings in which you stay, the wires that carry current, right? So everything, like most of the things, you can say that they are made up of metals. So you can say that metals are serving just as a major use. They are just serving as a major use. And you know that from where we get those metals, they are not present in a ready to use form in the earth, right? Like because the first thing is that you get metals from the earth. This should be clear in your mind, that from where do you get the metals? You get it from the earth crust. But the metals are not present in the earth crust as such. It's not like that you'll just take a metal from the earth crust and just make it use as a utensil or make it use as a jewelry. No, it's not like that, right? You have to take certain scientific processes are involved actually through which you can just make the ready to use form of metal. That means you have to convert the raw form into the ready to use form, right? So this is what is the main concern in our topic, that how we get that ready to use metal. Like the industries which are running, actually you go there and you ask for a steel, you go there you ask for an iron, you go there you ask for a sodium. So it's not like that they have ready to use form. They have actually set up a plant where they are just using certain n number of steps, you can say they are using just n number of steps through which they obtain the metal. Like that means they are just extracting metal from the earth crust. So the first thing is that the metals, that should be clear in your mind, that the metals do not occur in earth crust in a free state, right? They do not occur in a free state. They occur in a combined state. I'll write here, they occur in a combined state. Though we get many metals which occur in free state also, like for example carbon, sulfur, gold, etc. But the most of the metals which occur in the nature occur in the earth crust, it occurs in a combined state. Right, and you know that combined form not only carries the metal actually, it also carries the impurities along, like the sand, the plants, the microorganisms, the clay. There are n number of substances which are actually present along with the metal. And you know that substance is something called as ore. That is something called as ore. Right. So ore is actually a raw form of metal, and from that raw form you have to extract your metal, and that metal which you obtain is not a pure metal still, right? You need to carry out certain processes, and after that it becomes into a ready to use form. So that means here our concern is that we have to obtain pure metal from ore. We have to obtain pure metal from ore. Now, as far as the ores is concerned, I'll make you familiar with few terms. The one term is mineral. Now, what is mineral? This term is derived from the term mines. This word is derived from the term mines. So, mineral, what is mineral actually? Mineral is any substance that is found in earth crust. Like, suppose you just break a rock and in that you found something, so that is a mineral, right? So mineral is any substance that you found in an earth crust is called as mineral. And the mineral in which the metals are present, or you can say mineral from which metal can be extracted, that is something called as ore. So I think it's clear that mineral is concerned with any substance which you are just digging the earth and you are getting it. So that substance is called as mineral. But all minerals are not ores. Only that mineral is said to be an ore from which you can extract the metal. And you know that the process in which you are extracting metal from its ore, that step is something called as a process, or you can say is something called as metallurgy. So here the metallurgy consists of n number of steps, you can say they consist of n number of steps you will be carrying out, in which you will just obtain, the main thing is that we are going to obtain a pure metal from the ore. So this is what is the metallurgy. So what is metallurgy? If like write in your copies, it is a process by which you can obtain metal, pure metal from its ore, pure metal from its ore. Now we have studied like there are many, you can say it is not like that one element has only one ore or the certain element has only two ores. It's not like that. We get variety of ores, like means some metals are combined with the oxygen, some are combined with the carbonate, some may occur in combination with the sulfur. So that means each element can have more than one ore. It's not compulsory thing that it is going to possess only one ore. It's not like that. It can have you can say present in a combined form with some other elements also. So but the mainly like the main ores which we found in the nature is mostly carbonate ores, oxide ores, sulfide ores, and also halite ores. These are actually the common ores, you can say. These are actually the common ores which we see that the element are combined with the certain carbonate, oxygen, sulfur, halogen. So they occur in such and such kind of ores. Now in earth crust, like when we see a globe or when you look at the earth crust, actually you know that in certain areas we found a certain type of ore, in a certain area we found a certain type of ore. That means the ore distribution is not uniform. Ore distribution is not uniform. Like somewhere there are certain you can say the earth crust is rich in certain metal, and there are certain areas where the earth crust is rich in certain metals. So that means the ore distribution is not uniform. Ore distribution is not uniform, right? So this is what is the mineral, ore, metallurgy, the types of ores. And one more thing I would like to make you familiar with, that this thing, the ore actually is not I told you that it is ore doesn't only carry a metal. It carry along many substances, like it carries clay, it carries dust, it carries sand, it carries pebbles, it carries few microorganisms, it may carry certain insects, it's certain vegetation. So these all things which are present along with the metal in the ore, they are something called as impurities. They are something called as impurities. And now in this chapter, we will be using impurities, a new term for impurities, that is the gangue particles. That is the gangue particles, means the gang of particles, gang of undesired particles. So that means when we'll be starting the process, the first thing is that we need to remove all these things, because they may interfere in the when we take a certain step in order to obtain a pure metal. So they may interfere. So the very first step is that to remove these things, right? And for that we need to concentrate the ore. We'll take up different steps accordingly, like how they are taken up. We'll take in order that. But for this moment, I just may want to make you familiar that what are actually the gangue particles. So gangue particles are nothing, just the impurities which are present along with the metal in the ore, right? So all minerals are not ores. Let me clear this, right? All minerals are not ores. Only that mineral is said to be an ore from which you can extract certain metal. So this is what is the mineral, ore, the types of ores, the metallurgy, the process in which we carry out metal from the ore, and you say that metallurgy consists of n number of steps we'll be taking up now. It consists of n number of steps. Like after that, what you get, you are capable of converting the raw form of metal into a ready to use form of metal, right? So this is what, you are familiar with the gangue particles as well, right? Now the thing is that, like as I told you, that each element is not going to possess only one ore. So let me explain you with an example. Suppose I have zinc metal. I say it can be obtained for this ore, from this ore. Let my ore be ore 1. It can be obtained from this ore, let it be 2. It can be obtained from this ore, let it be 3. It can be obtained from other ore, let it be 4. Right. Suppose I say that when I get zinc, the 1 kg of zinc actually costs $100. This I have assumed, right? Suppose the 1 kg of zinc costs $100, and now I can get this pure form of zinc from this ore, that ore, this ore, and this one also. Suppose if I say like the cost involved when I get my zinc metal from this ore, let's say is $150, right? So likewise, if I obtain zinc from this ore, let's say the cost is $80. And likewise, if I obtain zinc from ore 3, let's say that cost is $100. And if I obtain the zinc from ore 2, so let's say the cost is $50. So that means here 1 kg of zinc, like if I'll sell the zinc, I'll be selling the zinc, 1 kg of zinc at $100, right? So which step would I prefer? Which ore would I prefer to take, right? So that means in that case, we need to select the economical method. We want to select an ore, even a method and also the ore that is more economical. So in this case, the economical ore is going to be the $80 one and the $50 one. So that means obviously I won't be using this and this because the cost is too high. So that means in selecting, in doing the metallurgical processes, we select an ore which is economical. Because after that, like we are going to sell it, and when we are going to sell it, we need to fetch profit also. So we'll fetch profit only when the cost of, the cost of the production or cost of the metallurgical processes are comparatively less. So likewise, we'll be selecting the ore which is cheap and which is more economical, right? But still, the quality also matters. But here also, when we will carry out certain processes, we need to look for the economical method. Definitely, we are in a search of economical method. So likewise, we'll be selecting only that ores which are economical. So that means the metal not only occur in one ore, as I told you, it occurs in many type of ores. But out of those ores, our main ore is one, and that ore is considered to be the important one, from which the yield is good and from which the quality is good, and even that process is economical, right? So that we can fetch the industries, I want to say that industries should possess certain profit also, right? So this is what is that, and now we are going to start with the types of the ores. Like, I just want to make you familiar that which element or metal is found in the earth crust and what is the percentage actually, and in which forms like their ores are existing. Either it's oxide or sulfide, carbonate or halite, as I told you that mostly they occur in such kind of ores form. So now we are going to start with the different types of ores which we get of different important metals.